COVID has broken down so much of resistance. I mean, did you ever think...
What does that mean, broken down resistance?
Did you think 10 years ago that the government could forcibly close our churches and arrest our priests and our pastors with the cardinal's acquiescence and the pastor's acquiescence, that our newspapers would openly be cheering, grocery store clerks would be heroes on one end, but priests who get sick and die of COVID are villains who deserve it? They get ha-ha'd in the New York Times and the Washington Post, Huffington Post, everywhere else. Did you think that we would be able to have people's lives ruined and their marriages broken and their businesses shut down and town centers ended and U.S. commerce ended, all in the name of COVID? But the American people seem to go along with it. And there's all in the name of an emergency order that's continued and continued and continued. And now it's part of the homeless camps. It's part of the emergency order. That is for public health. Your daughter is having excrement thrown at her while she walks to her internship because of public health. That's a public health measure.
Well, how does, pardon my ignorance, what does COVID have to do with homeless camps?
The CDC guidance has said that to break up homeless camps would spread COVID. Basically anything. I mean, fair elections would spread COVID. I mean, having any kind of election oversight would spread COVID. Teachers having to work would spread COVID. Breaking up homeless camps would spread COVID.
You know,
arresting people would spread COVID.
Disagreeing with BLM riots spreads COVID. I remember
that. Very much, yeah. That's the worst way to get it, too. And you'll deserve it.
How often do you bump up against COVID regulations? Like, how big a part of your life?
They got rid of it for a minute, but then I was kind of surprised that they did, right at the beginning of the vaccines. It's like, I didn't think this stuff was ever going away. And then they realized that they wanted it forever, so they brought it back. The warm weather broke some of the COVID craziness in the city because it's, above all, I mean, they try to be very Puritan and very strict in how they act and how they live their life, but they're really just self-centered and like a good time, like all of us, really.
Yes.
So when nice weather comes and the bars are open outdoors, because you're not allowed to eat indoors, you get COVID, we've all packed into outdoor spaces, tended to pack into baseball stadiums, pack into BLM riots and protests, of course. That started to break, but there's weird mask rules that have come into effect where you have to wear a mask. A lot of people are familiar with this. For the 8-foot walk through the crowded bar to sit down and then take it off again. So I was sitting at a great new restaurant that opened up, Caruso's Grocery, and I noticed that all the patrons surrounding this bar, none of them are wearing masks. They're all eating. They're all drinking. A lot of them probably, just statistically going off of how the city votes, a lot of them are probably hard left. But the wait staff, you know, the help, the servants, they have to cover their faces. They're right in the middle of this whole thing the whole time.
Can they make direct eye contact?
It's discouraged. They'll get hit. It's really definitely a class thing where you'll see that. The people who work for you have to wear a mask at all times, but you don't. Except when you're walking past the table. It just as like an homage to worshiping the hat or something. It's the new rule. And I'm always afraid they're going to do more.